YouTube, this is Andrea here, and we are off to a new page. The last page we made was this one here. We had this tag in this pocket, and there is a tuck spot here, and one here, and then one on this side. And there we go. And then one on the back. So let's put this back into their little pocket. So let's work on this one. I need a white sheet of paper just to go underneath so we know where our end and beginning is. There we go. I think I want to flip on this one. Let's see. I'm going to flip. And I think we're going to go quarter of an or a half an inch over. So that makes this sheet. Five inches, and then we're going to cut it right down here at the end, and that makes this side. Six and three quarters, 7 inches, makes this side 7 inches. Okay. Get that cut down. Okay. Let's go ahead and score it. What you can do when you're dealing with 8.5 by 11 paper is to take your long side of the paper and score it at the half inch mark. Or you can do it like I just did it and just measure it. Okay. I cut it a little short, so we'll do it again. Cut it almost a quarter of an inch off, which is not good. We said this was going to be 5. We are good there. And we should be much better here. Perfect. Okay. So that's our first flip, because I want to do another flip. Maybe that opens this way, or you know what, I'm going to do one that goes up. And we can use this one that we cut too short. We can use this to go up. No, because I'm still a quarter of an inch off. So we will not use that one. How about this one? I do like that. So let's go with this one. I'll go ahead and score it, and then we'll cut it down. Want to get it right up to the edge. And then you want to mark your bottom. Okay, here. And then we're going to have this flip go up. Now that we have this done, I want to work on pockets. So I would like a pocket, put this away, on the front of this one, and then the inside here. So let's do this first. Ahead, move our book. This is our flip. And I think we want a pocket there and possibly a pocket here. So a double pocket. Well, let's go with that. All right, so let's score this. Score both of them. And I just pull out scraps. That's why you don't see me cutting these pockets. I like to use up all my scraps. And then you don't feel like you're wasting money on all that paper you bought. Move this. We're going to use that again, but right now I just want to see where we're going to score it. Okay. So this bottom one, let's score that right there. This top one. I'm gonna score it right there. Perfect. This one I can cut down a little bit so that we are not too long, overly long on our pocket. Now we can bring these over. We're going to score these. Oop. Try. Well, I got these done. And they are going to come right up. And I'm going to glue them. Okay, so we have our pockets here, and I think I want to go ahead and do an edging on the pocket, and I would like to use this one here. Let's make our edging. Very pretty. I really like that. Just cut a little bit off. You don't have to cut a lot. It just helps everything slide in better. Okay, and we'll do the same on this one. This in our recycle bin and finish this up. There we go. Clean out our punch and then recycle again. Go ahead and cut this off. Now we have our pockets, and here is where you want to think about a closure. Let's get our book. Okay, this is the page we're working on. All right, so we have this flip here. Then we have this little flip here with two pockets. So what type of closure would we like to use? Do we want to use a magnet or ribbon or a swing tab? And you want to think about your closure before you put your paper down. And I think we're going to go with magnets. So let's put one on this. And then one on the flip on the inside. Get our double-sided tape. Pick up your magnet with it. And place it at the bottom, about a quarter of an inch away from the bottom, because your paper needs to come down here as well. Let's put our other magnet. It's going to go on top of this one. And then we're going to take a little piece of tape. Where are we going to take the tape? There we go. So that one is done, and it's going to go on top of this flip here. Now let's put this magnet up here. And it's going to go on the inside. Again, a little over a quarter of an inch. Your paper will take care of the rest around the magnet. Go ahead and put that there. It's a good magnet. It won't let go of the scissors. All right. Okay, so we have our magnets ready to go. We'll still need this. And then we have our pockets ready to go. So let's see how we want to do this. I think what I want to do is put paper on this flip before I put the pockets on. Yeah, that's what I'm going to want to do. So let's tape all this up. We're just going to put our tape down the middle. I always use a little glue to help it adhere better. Okay. I need to hold that one so tight. Too much on there. There we go. Okay, I'll get that off in a minute. There. All right. Okay, so we have this one going this way, this one going this way, and then our two pockets. Let's go ahead and get paper ready for all three of these. We'll start with I'm going to start with the two flips and the pockets. Let's pick paper. Okay. Now, last paper we used was this. So we have those three colors. Let's go ahead and put down this flip first. I don't know if this is that the same length? I'm gonna have to go with the longer one. This one is pretty. One, this is pretty. We can go with purple here, and then this on our pockets to match that. Let's do that. See, that wasn't difficult at all. Clean up a little bit. Okay, let's get this one done first, because it's our longer piece. That looks good. That cut. I really like that. Let's set that aside and go for our pockets. I'm going to burnish the pocket down here, because we don't want to waste paper by doing the whole thing. You only want to do the section that can be done. Okay. I would like to have is this one here? Oh, here. Let's do it this way. Okay, because I want a little bit of the flowers on this pocket. So we'll cut it here. On here. Looks good. Okay. So we've got this piece here. Maybe I'll flip it over like that. Yeah. that goes on this pocket, and the way I'm going to remember that is to mark them. So one, one. Okay, put that aside. So let's work on this pocket. This one, we're going to have the same thing, except we're going to put the flower in the middle this time. Let's see, here and here. Cut that. That one goes here, and then we can mark our bottom. Okay. This is two and two. Okay, when you're using same paper on different items, it's really best to go ahead and mark that so you don't forget where it goes. I used to forget all the time, which is why I mark it. Okay, then we need this one. What do we have? I could go there. This gold is really pretty. Let's see what it looks like. So we have the gold. This is gold foil. Then we would have this flip, which is the lavender with butterflies. Then we would have these two pockets. I think the gold foil looks really nice. Let's just look at one more. Or two more, or three more. Let's no. How about this one? This one kind of goes with the blue. I like that. That looks pretty. I like the blue. It's like a robin's egg blue, or maybe darker. Okay, let's go with the blue. Maybe we can use that gold on the inside, the one with the gold foil. That's too short. So let's try that again. Hopefully we have another piece. Okay. So where was I? I was over here. This is the closest blue. Let's see. Yeah, so this one's same color. All right, so we will go with that. Yeah, I want the border to be not so big. We got a good cut this time. Yeah, perfect. So let's flip this over and we're going to need a piece for inside. Alright, now I think I want to go ahead and use the gold foil. On this piece. That is good. All right, and we need a piece for the inside slip. So here, these two go on here. And we have to get one for the inside here. And it needs to kind of coincide with that one. So let's find a piece. I think we need flowers on this one. That or something solid, or more solid, more so solid. Well, I don't see why we can't use this one again, but I was looking at this, and I thought, aren't those gold polka dots pretty? So I think I'm gonna use both of these. One I'm gonna put on the back of this flip. And that's going to coincide with this. So we'll have this one up like this. Oh, that's pretty. Okay. Let's do that. All right, that looks good, nice and fit. Now we can do our page paper for this one, and all we need is this flip and the inside sheet, which is this one. And we're just gonna flip it over like so. put the inside sheet here and then see what goes with it. I really think we should use this only because it will then tie in our flowers on the pocket. Okay, so let's go with that. Put that aside. And then we want to leave at least 1/8 of an inch of a border. Gonna go on there. All right. Now we can get all of our papers together, our decorative papers. Flip that over because I don't want to accidentally glue up the wrong side. All right. We'll set these aside. And we will assemble our flips and pockets, all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and tape these pockets up. Do our other one. Now the pockets cannot go on the flip until you put the paper down. So those get set to the side. But your two flips can go down onto the base page. Now, all right, you see me gluing. I just want to point out, if you wanted to use a ribbon, you can either put it in this section and then glue this down, or flip this over and put the ribbon in here and then use that. But you would also need to glue the ribbon for this side as well. So it's up to you. All the way to the edge. Okay, we'll do our flip. Our skinny flip. There it goes. Right on here. Try to make it centered and even. I always eyeball it, but if you want to measure it to get the center, be my guest. Okay. All right. We got those on. So now, put this away. Now I'm going to ink up all my edges, make these into stickers, and I'll be right back. All right, so we are back and we have made our stickers. We are going to put the pockets aside, and this flip aside and then work on the inside first. So let's take off our background or our tape backing. Try to remember you have tape backing there. I have in the past accidentally left the tape backing on and covered it up with my sticker paper. So let's see. We had this for this. I did pick out a flower to put on this page here. And we're going to make it so that you could put a photo in there this way. So we'll glue it across here and down here, allowing a photo to go right on top, or right inside the top. Okay. This goes here. Yes, it goes here. We want to stay clear of the score line. Let me just make sure I'm in the right spot. Perfect. All right. And we are good that way. Perfect. I love the paper, this Anna Griffin paper. It's all cardstock, but you guys, you use whatever you want. You don't have to use this particular paper. Let's see, which way do we want this to flow? So we're going to go work around this score line. Ooh, that's a little off, but you guys know how I fix that. So let's go ahead and pull this paper. Get this burnish down real good. Get your Sharpie and a ruler that has a flat edge. And then put your ruler down straight and then color all the way up with your Sharpie in a straight line. Voila! All better. Okay. I might even trim a little bit. Just a little tiny bit. Yeah. Make sure this is covered up. Okay, that's all better now. And this still magnetizes. Let's go ahead and put our flower on. Where did we put that little sucker? Right here. Okay. Put our flower on. And I want it to be in the middle like so. Yeah. So I'm just going to do half of the flower itself. And then all of the bottom. Burnish that down. Excuse me. You can always tell it's winter time. Sniffling and coughing. All right, we are done with that. So let's flip this up and let's work on this piece here. Move our tape backing. And then I have this flower for this one here. And this one's gonna go underneath. This is not directional, so whether I turn it or not doesn't matter. I need to pull this back up because that is not, there we go, what I want. Let me do it from the bottom. Put our paper back in there. Yeah. There we go. That was a disaster averted. Okay, and we have this piece that goes here. That is our cream and gold polka dot. All right. I am going to use my ruler because that didn't go down as planned. We're just having all kinds of goof-ups tonight. Okay. Alright. But at least we have ways to fix it. That's what's important. So it doesn't matter, you don't have to be perfect. Just remember there's always ways to fix it. Well, that goes there, and then we have our flower. Put this away. Put this away. Find our flower. And this flower is going to go in the middle as well, and then we're going to leave this top open. And we'll do it like that. Let's go ahead and do it like that. This time, I'm just going to take my finger and rub that around. Get every little part there. That's much better. Much, much better. Okay. So we will flip this down. And we have this piece here. And this goes on before we put our pockets on. If you're wondering why I do this and you haven't seen any of my videos before, this is me rolling the glue back onto itself so that it doesn't stick out. Perfect. Now we have our pockets. We need to put some tape on this side. This one's all done. We're going to put the bottom one on first so that we could measure up for the second one. As soon as we get our tape backing off. All right. We know we want it at the bottom. Okay. Now we want this one to go right about here. Little bit of glue. Little bit of glue will do ya. So if you count from the bottom of the flip, the first pocket goes two inches, leaving here, this is about 2 2/8. And then from the bottom of the flip up to the top, the big pocket starts, let's see, at the 1 inch mark and ends at the 2.5 inch mark. So you'll come up, this will be a total, let's get my where this pocket is, of 5.5 inches just for the pockets. So that's 5.5 inches. If you go past that, you're going to find it having a problem with putting tags in here. All right. Now, this is number one. So pretty. And number two. See, it really ties in that blue. Perfect. Now, let's get those tags done for these two pockets. So this flips open here. We have a spot here. Let's see. A little spot there. And then here, we have a little spot here. Let's put in a smaller piece. Oh brother, I might not have a smaller piece. Oh, here's one. Yeah. So that's there. And then we need tags for here. Here. Maybe. No. I don't know about that one. How about we try? No, that'd be too much. Okay. I like the gold polka dots because they kind of like not really clashing. They're not clashing with anything. All right, so I'm gonna cut up some tags and I'll be right back. All right, so I picked some green paper. I think it's really pretty. This is what it had on there. I think it goes well. And it's bright and cheery. Put together on our tags. Our big tag goes on top like so, and we have our little tag. And that goes in the bottom pocket. And we are done. That is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Have a great one. Bye.